I'm Sarah Sterelli, on a quest to discover the people behind the cutting-edge innovations across industries, to tell the stories that define them far more than their titles. My guest today is Olivia Peterson. Well, thanks so much, Olivia, for being here with me on the vodcast today. Greatly appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you for having me, Sarah. I'm really excited to have a conversation with you and also just to share some of my stories and experiences here at Amazon.
Amazing. Well, let's dive in. Okay. My first question for you today is, who has inspired you the most along your journey?
Yeah, I've been fortunate to have a number of leaders who've inspired me. However, I think what forms, you know, so many of our early impressions and goals starts at home. So I would say, you know, my mother, in the sense that she had a career, just seeing her be able to balance that with motherhood, I think that's inspiring and kind of set the bar there. But also just the diligent and tenacious work ethic that she had really instilled that into me. But then I would say I had, you know, the great pleasure of even early on in my career having some great leaders who also just set the right precedent for me in terms around like what you focus on, what's most important, how to be a pragmatic and thoughtful leader, and really, you know, where to dive deep and really understanding those signals. So I'd say in each of the different chapters, and I always think of a career being a chapter of decades. So in each of those decades, I've had the opportunity to really be inspired by and developed by, you know, some fantastic leaders. And I would say, you know, Dave Levy, I'll make a plug, is one who I would definitely count here at Amazon. Just, you know, the level of humility, but also just real customer obsession and driving with that is really inspiring. And it's actually what brought me here to Amazon too.
That's amazing. Well, I agree. And to that point, which is your favorite Amazon leadership principle out of all of them and why?
Well, I originally was a customer of AWS. So I especially appreciate customer obsession. And as a customer, I felt that. So understanding how really just that work backwards process too is about driving towards outcomes, how to be succinct, and moving away, even from those of us who kind of grew up in a consulting capacity, which is how I started my career, you find that there's just so many kind of fluffy angles that you focus on. Mm-hmm. And underlying all of that is the real substance of what needs to happen and what the outcome needs to be. And I would say something that I've really taken from Amazon and I was drawn to is understanding what matters most to the customer, staying focused on that, and really being obsessed about that, not as much about, you know, some of the distractions or noise in the environment, but really staying focused on what matters most. So that is always my favorite.
Agreed. I know I have noticed that even in my personal life too, of all of a sudden applying the leadership principles, be like, what are you talking about? I'm like, oh, Amazon brain, you know, but they are incredibly applicable really throughout all of life and in the various stages, right? And deliver results.
What is it you're trying to do? Yes, exactly.
You know, so given you do run the, you know, federal financial space, I'd love to know from you what generative AI opportunities you think exist for it.
Yeah, of course. And this is a conversation that is just amazing because these are conversations that I'm having with our customers at the board level and at the COO, the CEO, the president, because they understand this is something that is going to be assistive technology for their entire workforce, but also an opportunity to reimagine. And some examples that I see immediately coming into play, one in terms of fighting financial crime. Financial data is really a matter of national security now. I think we see that just by way of all of the global events that are happening, but also just in terms of how you think about financing of a lot of criminal activity. And if we look at the application of generative AI, we already have great evidence towards not only reducing rates of false positives, but also increasing the identification of what needs to get investigated. Mm-hmm. So some great examples that we already have in production today. Verafin, who is a NASDAQ company, is leveraging this right now for their investigations in terms of wire fraud. And they already have had a 25% reduction in terms of false positives, but a 250% increase around tagging those incidents that require investigation. The other piece is just hugely customized customer experience. They're able to get new products and offerings that are really tailored to their needs. We had another financial services customer NatWest, who leveraged this to really share out some of their new product offerings. As a result, they had a 900% increase in applications for high interest bearing accounts. Because again, those might not be things that people go looking for, but when it's suggested to them, based off of their qualifications already, it's something that they're able to act on. So that's really great. And then, of course, there's so much around efficiencies. And this is really where we're seeing the first use case is internal efficiencies. So I work across all of our financial regulators. There's so much in the way of disclosure documentation and other legal documents that really need to be poured through in order to synthesize whether or not compliance exists or whether or not there are areas for investigation. A lot of that is what we're seeing our customers also even going into the tax code or other just really onerous documentation to be able to summarize that, bring main points together, and also just be able to identify compliance. And again, all of these technologies are assistive. We don't see them as replacing that human element, but they're really gonna supplement it in a way that the humans, the analysts, can really focus on those differentiated areas as opposed to combing through to identify and spending all of their hours in terms of where to look. They spend that instead really diving deep. So I think there's gonna be some great application. And you know, it's really amazing just how quickly we've seen it evolve. Right. But I think over the next year too, we're going to see even more, particularly as customers are really getting their data in order and harnessing the power of that data. Because of course, everything with Gen AI starts with how clean and how organized and how accessible your data is. So there's a lot that we're doing now, and I know that the use cases are going to continue to grow.
That's amazing. My goodness. Yeah. I mean, thank you for sure. I know it's going to be heavily influential for our listeners. Another question I have. So given as a leader and at AWS, you know, and a woman in the workplace, and you touched upon this a little bit, you know, how important is that to you also to be, you know, inspiring the next generation or getting more women into not only the workforce, but in the technology space and even into, you know, FedFin?
It's very important. And, you know, it has to start, and it does start with how we recruit. So at our DC summit in June, I launched our Women in Federal Affinity Group. And I'm really excited because a lot of our customers aren't necessarily able to have their own affinity groups. So while at Amazon, we've been internally focused in supporting each other, this is something that we're really opening up to our customer communities. And it's so important not only to support the networking and the connection because we are the minority, but also to do that at all phases of the career. I have a daughter, so it's really important to me too that women of all ages don't see this as something that's not for them. So Reinvent, as you know, is a massive event, and a goal that I have is one day to stand in line at the ladies' room, because in the 6 years that I've gone, that's the place that you get some quiet, because there's no one in there. So I think it is hugely important, because it's not only with women, but just diversity in general is important, to have different experiences and different perspectives that we're bringing in, but also our customers are diverse,
right?
And they need to see themselves in us. So I think that that's incredibly important. So I'm really grateful for the fact that we have the right platform here at Amazon to welcome others in. We are supportive of that. And we just need to pull someone else in and pull someone else along. I think that's really important.
No, that's amazing. Again, you know, thank you so much. My final question for you today is actually, what do you want to be known for to future generations?
Yeah. I always want to be thought of as kind, you know, so I try to lead with kindness personally and professionally, assume positive intent for the people that you're interacting with. I want to be remembered as a leader who brought my authentic self, who empowered others, and maintained that focus on kindness to create a psychologically safe environment for my team to thrive in, and also for customers, you know, to be that connective tissue. I often refer to that with my team of be the fascia. I've always in my career, and you know, my background was in financial engineering, so it was much more business focused initially and structured finance. But then very quickly I found there was this missing bridge between tech speak and business speak. And I found that that was something that not only did I enjoy being that translator, but I really enjoyed being the connector. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, that's something that I want to be remembered as is, you know, I helped each person be better together.
I love it. Well, thank you so much, Olivia, for all of your responses today and the wonderful information and even how, you know, the FedFin space is helping our customers fulfill their mission. So thank you so much for all that you're doing, and especially even being an inspiration for all women out there to continue to move forward. And thank you for bringing those of us along with you.
Yeah, happy to. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.